Hi everyone, thank you for joining us today for our December Career Cafe on careers in healthcare and nursing. We're so fortunate to have with us today Ms. LEANNE.M. KAMPMANN, Executive Director of Ashland Nursing and Rehab Center, and Ms. Jennifer Boulding, Licensed CNA and Medication Aide at Westminster Canterbury Richmond, and she's also a school counselor at Glen Allen High School in Henrico County. So we are so appreciative of them taking their time to share their expertise with us today. And with that, I'm going to give this over to Ms. LEANNE.M. KAMPMANN so she can get started.
Hi, thank you both very much. I'm glad to be with you guys today and share my experience and talk a little bit about Ashland and the career opportunities that we have here in healthcare. As April said, my name is LEANNE.M. KAMPMANN, and I'm the Executive Director here at Ashland Nursing and Rehab. So first, I'd like to just share a little bit about us. We are a fairly large facility. We are 190 beds. We do offer skilled services, long-term care, and memory care. In addition to that, we also offer rehab services to include physical, occupational, and speech therapy. A lot of our patients have different levels of acuity, but we are lucky here to have nurses with experience that we are able to offer care for medically complex patients. In addition to that, we also have restorative services. We do admission and discharge planning here at Ashland. So as you can imagine, that allows us to offer a wide array of job opportunities, not just in nursing, but also in administration and in our environmental services. As far as careers in long-term care, here at Ashland, we're excited that you're interested in healthcare as a potential future career. We were actually talking right before this. Myself and Jennifer both have been in different positions within healthcare. A little bit about me, I did start off as a CNA in my healthcare journey, and I did that for about 7 years before moving into a staffing position and then into admissions, and then obtained my state licensure to be a long-term care administrator. If you're interested in healthcare, that probably means that you've been doing a little research on the different areas and careers that healthcare has to offer. Long-term care is always looking for individuals that are aspiring to take their healthcare careers or future in healthcare to the next level. So I would definitely encourage anybody that's interested in long-term care or even in healthcare at all to reach out to our HR or even any of our staff members to, you know, give that little word of advice or maybe ease any anxieties that you might have about healthcare, because we're also always looking for any additional medical expertise for those interested in nursing. So with that being said, I'd like to share a few career opportunities that Ashland has to offer. And I'll begin in our administrative areas. So healthcare does not just revolve around nursing, even though that's a huge part of it. I myself started off, like I said, as a CNA. So I was very much in the clinical aspects of my journey there, and then moved into the administrative side of healthcare. So obviously we do offer several opportunities in administration to include receptionist positions, what we are calling a concierge position. As most of you know, COVID has changed the outlook of healthcare completely. And so that position allows us to be able to maintain regulatory status with screening without taking away from day-to-day operations of other administrative and clerical staff. Specialty services that we offer would be social work and recreational activities. And then, of course, we have several positions in environmental services to include dietary workers, housekeeping services, laundry, floor techs, and maintenance. But I'm sure what most students are interested in this virtual cafe is our nursing areas. As you know, there are different levels of schooling that you'd have to go through, but we do offer positions here for registered nurses, licensed practical nurses, certified nurses aides, personal care aides, which are more or less able to assist our CNAs. So they don't do direct care with the patients, but they can assist in areas like making beds or passing trays, some of those little things that, you know, allows our CNAs to focus on the care areas of our residents without being taken away, and then the job still gets done. So personal care aides are a big asset to us and a good way for you to kind of get your feet wet if you're thinking about becoming a CNA. It allows you to kind of see what would happen, what you'd have to do, and the clinical aspects of the job. And then we also offer careers for feeding assistants. And then just to let you guys know, we do have some future opportunities that we're working on here at Ashland. We're always looking for new ways to offer career opportunities and educational opportunities, not just to the staff here, but to our potential staff and folks in the community. That allows us to grow, but it also brings a new level of care to the facility that we can offer to our residents. So we're excited to say that in the future, we are planning to offer a state certified nurses aid program. That's a 120-hour program that is licensed by the state that we would do in-house, both the written and clinical areas of that. And then from there, we would be able to offer you a 120-day temporary position that you'd be able to work as a CNA before you'd have to obtain your licensure from the state. So it's a good program to have, because you get to take your class, you get to have that bonding moment with your residents, and then from there you can really decide if, you know, Ashland is the place for you, or if there's another direction that you wanted to go as a CNA. And then it allows us to help you set up to take your test with the state. And then we go through a process of continued education and training to make sure that you're prepared for that state licensure exam. The other thing that we're also doing is, just like the CNA program, we do have a feeding assistance job. However, we do offer the feeding assistance program to our PCAs to be able to train them to become feeding assistants as well. Additionally to that, if you're still on the fence a little bit, I would encourage you to volunteer. And if you're not on the fence and it's just something that you want to do as volunteer, I definitely always push that and encourage volunteering. Healthcare, long-term care facilities are always looking for volunteers. It's a great way to determine if you want to work in long-term care. It also allows, you know, our residents to get that extra companionship. And it allows us to be able to offer a wider variety of activities and programs for our residents. So again, I hope that I get to speak to you all. And if you're interested in employment or in the classes, I encourage you to reach out to us. And I've provided our phone number and a list of contacts that would be more than happy to speak to you and answer any questions that you might have. So, and I'll run through them real quick. Kimberly Springs, who is our human resources director, if you did decide to come to Ashland for employment, then she would go through the orientation process with you. Kimberly herself is also a CNA. Alicia Carter, our staffing coordinator, also a CNA. She is responsible for staffing the building, so she can definitely give you her experience and what she does and how she's grown. Angela McClain is our director of nursing, and her assistant director of nursing is Brittany Hunter. Both of them are RNs. And then, of course, myself, I'm the executive director here. And again, I do encourage you to give us a call or reach out to us in any way. And we'll be happy to answer any questions that you have in regards to careers in healthcare.
Thank you so much, LEANNE. That information is so informative for our students. It sounds like you guys have some really exciting opportunities. We had a question in the chat. Does the volunteering have an age minimum?
So most of the time, I'll be honest, most of the time it's 18, but we have partnered up with different teenagers that are under the age of 18. There's a difference. So we would have to do like a background check and regulatory stuff, but we can definitely look at it. It would be a case by case basis. We also do, if you are a part of other groups like Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, you know, any kind of community program that's offered out there, we do like to work with them as well and be able to partner with them and see where we can take that.
Awesome. Thank you so much. So now we're going to move on to Miss Jennifer Boulding, and she is our CNA with Westminster Canterbury Richmond and a school counselor at Glen Allen High School. Thank you, Jennifer, for joining us today.
Thank you all for having me. I'm excited to talk about my role as a CNA. I am currently licensed as a certified nursing assistant. That is what a CNA is. I'm happy to be in that role. And a lot of times we do get that question even to this day. They might say, what is the role of the CNA? And again, we work with the daily living activities for the patients. We follow the direction of a registered nurse or an LPN. You've heard earlier that we can be referred to as nursing assistants, patient care assistants, or nurse aide. It's very important to understand that the CNA is the beginning level of nursing. I always say, and we talked about it earlier, it can be the challenging part of nursing. We always hear those stories about, oh my God, you're going to be doing so many different jobs that may be, feel uncomfortable to you, but it is, to me, it's an exciting job. If you want to be a certified nursing assistant, it's very important to understand what those duties entail. So when we talk about the daily living skills, we are talking about how to make that person comfortable throughout their day-to-day activities, from when they first get up in the morning till they go to sleep at night. And so it's exciting to know that if you're going into nursing, you need to know some of those basic skills in how to perform that, okay? What do the duties look like? Again, you heard me say daily living skills. It's personal care. It is washing their hair, taking a shower, taking them to the restroom, making sure that they're comfortable, feeding them, making sure that you're able to provide day-to-day assistance to those residents, and making sure that they're comfortable and making sure that they're happy within their space. We assist with activities. A lot of times the facilities are busy. My role is to make sure that if there are sing-alongs going on or there are different activities, that I assist in getting the patients to those activities as safely as possible. So we deal with the activities department or the recreational department. And then any directive that, and you'll learn this as you get more and more into the professions, we follow a resident's care plan. So we look at when we come in to work and we look at what that individual needs, it's called a care plan. And so we follow all of the orders that's on that care plan for that individual to make sure that we are caring for them as instructed. We also, it's very important to understand that we follow the direction of an RN or LPN. Our instructions come from the nurse. If we see things or we observe things for patients that are unusual or that the nurse wants to see more of. You've heard LEANNE say earlier, they have individuals doing feeding or making sure they're hydrated. Our role is to make sure that those duties are performed as scheduled and making sure that we're consistent with what the nurses and the doctors are saying. So we do follow strict guidelines from the registered nurses and the LPNs as well. What steps do you take to become a nursing assistant? You've heard a little bit of that from Leanne. It is a 120-hour program. A lot of our students myself, I went to Reynolds Community, now called Reynolds Community College. I did their program and it was awesome. I did the classroom portion. And then I actually did my clinicals at Westminster Canterbury, which is how I ended up being employed there. I did my clinicals there for a certain amount of hours and a certain amount of weeks. And we did everything that the nurses had us to do. But you really go in and do hands-on experience with the patients, even in the training program. So you would be doing a lot of one-on-one with those patients under the direction of an RN. A lot of students can become a nursing assistant, a certified nursing assistant, by technical programs that they have. We have technical programs, I know, in Henrico County. I think that you all have technical programs in Hanover County as well. There are private trade and technical programs that are out there. There are tons of them that are out there that students can become a nursing assistant with. And then we're always excited to hear that you can actually be a part of a facility. So if you went to Ashland now has their certified nursing assistant program that they will bring aboard. So there's so many ways and so many programs that's out there that will allow you the opportunity to study and actually study and go into the educational piece, the instructional piece in the classroom. And then you have the option to do the clinical piece. A lot of times when you're in programs like Ashland, you can do the clinical piece, of course, right there. But if you do something like Reynolds, you're taken, of course, a lot of times they coordinate with facilities and then you'll do your clinicals. We would do our clinicals on the weekend at Westminster Canterbury. So we would be there very early getting our hours in. So that's really important to understand that after doing the schooling part, it's important to know that you will take a state certified program. A lot of the facilities want you to be certified. I am still certified. I still hold my certification and have held my certification for many years through the Commonwealth of Virginia Board of Nursing. So it's very important to understand that you will take the class, you will do your clinicals, but then you sit for the official examination so that you're certified by the Board of Nursing for the Commonwealth of Virginia. So that's important to know as well. The programs are a lot of times flexible. A lot of times there's day programs, evening programs, and some have even gotten creative. There are weekend programs as well because of clinicals. So there are various programs out there. I would just say do your research in terms of making sure that the programs are appropriate for you and understanding that when you get into these programs, again, you're mandated to follow state guidelines about what it takes to be a CNA. And to understand that the CNA is the beginning part of nursing. It's the beginning part of nursing. Some students go on and study to become, you know, an RN, and that's awesome, or LPN. But understand that it is the foundation of nursing. The counselors heard me say before that I had a girlfriend. She went on to become an RN, but she skipped the CNA program. And what she came back to share with me was that she wished that she had done the beginning, the foundation of nursing, which is certified nursing assistant, the more challenging part, because it makes you more comfortable in dealing with the patients, being able to do those skills, practice those skills that are challenging for you, and be able to be comfortable in that role as a nurse. And so I encourage students also to this day to certainly get those skills as a certified nursing assistant. If you choose to move on further as an LPN and RN, those options are certainly awesome and available to you.
Thank you so much. That information is so helpful for our students that are looking at becoming CNAs or that are already in a program for CNAs. So we really appreciate your expertise in that field. And also, we think it's so interesting that you decided to be a CNA after you were a school counselor. So you're yes. still a school counselor, but you're also a CNA at the same time. So you're doing both.
Yes, I actually earned my bachelor's and master's degree. And then I've always had a love for nursing. And believe it or not, I've always wanted to be a CNA. And I had already earned, again, 2 degrees and went back later to become a CNA and was very excited when I did. I do practice as a CNA today. I practice also as a medication aide, where I give Medicaid. You have to be a CNA in order to do that. So I got a little bit of additional training. And so I dispense medication in the assisted living part. But yes, I've done that after getting my master's degree. I went on to practice and study to become a CNA and was excited and still excited and still do practice as a CNA to this day. And it's really exciting.
Thank you. So now we have some time for questions for our students that are watching. If you want to put a question in the chat, that is fine. We'll be happy to get to you. Or you can unmute yourself and we will answer some questions.
LEANNE, I do have a question. I wanted to ask about with the volunteering, if it can be flexible for students, if they were able to do it with you all, can you be flexible in terms of hours? Is it typically would it be like during the week after school or on the weekends? Just curious about that.
Yeah, so in my past, I have worked very flexible with students who were interested in a volunteering program. So that could be anything from after school, or if they have, I know some high schools have it where they may only go to school half a day or something along those lines. So we've had them come in for the other half of the day. I've even had students come in on the weekends and do volunteer hours on the weekends. So.
Okay. Thank you.
And we have some questions in the chat. So one of them was, do you need to have good grades for the volunteering program? Is that something you guys take into consideration?
No, we do not look at grades for the volunteer program.
All right, perfect. And then another question, someone was wondering if you had any information about becoming a physician's assistant.
So I will tell you that is not my expertise. But we do have, so we actually have quite a few PAs that work here in our facility. Generally, they're here 6 days a week. So, and they are very open to communicating with students or anybody that's interested. So if that is something that you're highly interested in, want a little more insight or information on, we can definitely get students in touch with them.
Wonderful. Thank you. Any other questions?
I have one last question. So just with the environment we're in right now, COVID, are there any barriers or anything that students need to be aware of in trying to get experience in this day and time in the healthcare field?
So the ultimate answer to that is yes. yes, as Shannon said, things in healthcare have changed drastically with COVID. So there are different regulatory processes that we have to follow, not just for the resident safety, but also for the student safety and their families and the community. So it really depends on where you are at as a facility. With COVID, I'm sure a lot of people have been hearing in the media that the cases are rising and stuff again. So we do have to take some additional precautions. And again, right now with COVID, it is kind of a case by case basis that we have to look at. But we also, I think Jennifer can probably feel me on this a little bit. We're ready to get back to life and be able to offer those services back to our residents because they definitely miss it. So I would definitely still encourage anybody, any student that's interested in whether it's volunteering or, you know, a career opportunity with our facility or any facility for that matter, to reach out to them and see what they are able to do right now with COVID.
Thank you so much. That's very encouraging.
I just want to share with the COVID piece that when you, and LEANNE, you can chime in on this, when you take the oath to become a CNA or any form of nursing, you take an oath to care for individuals no matter what the danger is out there. And so you have to, if you're looking at studying to become a nurse at all, CNA, LPN, RN, or physician assistant, understand that we are under oath to care for the sick. And so if you take that oath seriously, it is times where in which we're faced with now, it is times that we will be on the floors in situations such as what we're faced with now. And so I just wanted to stress that because, again, we do take an oath to care for the sick, even in stressful times such as this.
Yes, I, Jennifer, I back you 100% on that. And I think COVID is new for all of us and something that kind of caught us all off guard, whether you're in healthcare or not. But most definitely, you know, regardless of what area of healthcare you're in, you take that oath and you keep on trucking day by day. Mm-hmm. You're going to have good days, you're going to have bad days, but that's what we're here for.
Right.
One last question. We had a question in the chat. You guys have mentioned LPN, RN, CNA. What is the difference in training for LPN and RN as compared to CNA?
So it doesn't matter either way. As an LPN, typically what I've seen for LPN programs is you're looking at a year to 18 months for education. And then for an RN, you're looking at 2 years plus, depending on if you want to specialize or if you want to get, higher degree in nursing with your RN. So it's really up to you. But like Jennifer was saying early on in the chat, I would definitely advise to go the CNA route, begin there, and really get a feel for it. I will say in my personal experience, kind of like Jennifer was talking about her friend that became an RN, what I've seen multiple times is people that take the CNA class, become CNAs, do CNA work, even if it's while you're attending school to get your LPN or your RN. They come out so much more prepared and so much more knowledgeable in all areas, whether it's clinical, whether it's that bedside manner, the communication process in nursing and healthcare, which is so important. There's just so much to it that, you know, as a CNA, you really get to be in the forefront of all of it and take it all in and get to use that experience and that knowledge. And I think it just makes you, again, so much more prepared for, you know, whether it's an LPN, an RN, or even going to get your PA. So I hope that answered the question a little bit.
It does. Thank you. And if students have questions beyond today, as they're watching the video later, or they think of something else, is it okay if they reach out to you directly, or do you want them to reach out to us and we pass their information along to you?
Yeah, I'm fine with either way. I will be honest, if you guys want to, as far as a direct contact for me, because I tend to be on the go all day long, email is probably the best way to directly communicate with me. So I'm absolutely fine with you guys sharing my email. And then if you have any additional questions or you wanted to talk to somebody in general, I can either hook you up with the best contact for the information you're looking for, or, you know, schedule a time for a phone call, anything that helps our students, you know, with this career process.
Thank you. We really appreciate that. And Ms. Boulding, are you comfortable with us sharing your email as well?
Absolutely. You're welcome to share my email. I'll be glad to share any information in terms of my experience, like I said, as a CNA as well. So yes.
Perfect. So we will be sending out their contact information with this video today. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us. We're going to let you guys get off now. And we really appreciate you taking the time to share your expertise with our students. This has been really informative for us. And we hope that our students that are watching have gotten a lot out of it.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you all. Thank you, everyone, for joining us today. Thank you, Ms. Campman and Ms. Boulding. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.